I have severe scrupulosity. It gets pretty bad, like to the point I'm not sure how often I can trust myself. There's a verse in the Bible that's been troubling me, and it says, but the one who eats is condemned if he does eat, because his eating does not come from sin.
It doesn't come from faith. That's Romans chapter 14. Yes.
Is there a way to understand this without taking it way too far?
Here's the key. With dealing with scrupulosity, and I'm sure you know this, you really do need to get a spiritual director, a priest that you can talk to, because there's most often all sorts of psychological layers that sort of undergird scrupulosity, and there's so many different levels of scrupulosity. But you and I are so blessed to be Catholic because we have the magisterium of the Catholic Church. And the magisterium is the clearest antidote for scrupulosity. Because see, what Paul's talking about in Romans 14 were people who are being scrupulous over eating meats offered to idols. And this had been a huge issue in the first few decades of the Christian era. And so they were struggling over this. So the key is to listen to the voice of Jesus Christ, who speaks through scripture, tradition, and the magisterium of the church. You read through the letters of St. Paul, for example, and you can see just in St. Paul how he guides the discourse. But the key is for you, when you're in the midst of it, you listen to the mind of Christ as his voice comes through scripture, tradition, and the magisterium of the church. And that's going to help tremendously, right? And getting a good spiritual director so that you don't go to extremes. So the best combat against scrupulosity is the faith. And notice when Paul says that, you know, if you eat and you doubt, you're damned, because whatever does not come from faith is sin. He's actually saying whatever does not come from the faith is sin, right? He's not making this completely subjective, as some say, but he's telling his listeners, look, listen to me, I'm an apostle. Listen to the church and what the church says, and form your conscience in accordance with that teaching, and that will greatly aid you in overcoming. Listen to the magisterial teachings of the church that have dealt with these matters, and you'll find peace for your soul, brother.